If you're using Bolt, you're probably overlooking this hack that's going to save you a lot of time. Bolt has become one of the most popular AI app builders because of how much time it saves you. But with this hack, you're going to be able to save even more time and build even more quickly. In this video, we're going to use Bolt Starter, and I'm going to show you two specific use cases of how you can use Bolt Starter to build more quickly in Bolt. And at the end of the video, I'm going to give you a bonus tip that I've learned after building dozens of Bolt projects that I think is going to be helpful for you as well. So here we are in Bolt Starter. And what Bolt Starter allows you to do is start with templates totally for free inside of Bolt. So instead of starting from a completely blank page and prompting from the beginning, what you can do with Bolt Starter is use their template, click launch in Bolt New, or you can preview it as a live preview. So we can do that very quickly here. So this is an e-commerce template that you can start with in Bolt, for example. Here's a flight booking system that you can start with in Bolt. So you can start from a really good starting point and then iterate from there, as opposed to starting from scratch. This is a similar method that I've done using GitHub repositories that are public that you can fork for free and use that as a starting point if you're building with something like Cursor or Windsurf. But for Bolt, this is the best implementation that I've seen for starting with a template. So let's start first with the AI chat interface template. So we can click on the live preview really quickly and we can see this looks really awesome. So let's go back and let's launch in Bolt.new. So I'm going to click that button. It is going to import the repository into Bolt. And like Bolt Starter said, this does not use any tokens off the bat just to import until we start making changes. So here it can say I've imported your project. So now we are in our Bolt account. We haven't used any tokens and we have this entire template to build off of. So yeah, pretty awesome. And I think if I send a message, none of that's going to work because it's just the UI front end. But as the next step, we can make this a real app. So let's see how quickly we can go from template to working app. So I'm going to say in my prompt, let's add real AI functionality to this with a Perplexity API key. And I'll pause the video while it builds it out. So you just have to make sure you have a Perplexity API key. I'm going to say, yes, I have it. So now it's telling me I need to add my API key in the .env file. So I'm going to go to .env, paste that in. So I added the API key, and now I'm asking it to make it so we can actually create a new thread and send messages. And I'm starting by asking it to make sure everything is in local storage for threads and messages. And I'm not going to integrate Supabase for a backend database for this tutorial because I just want to show you how easy it is to go from the template to a working prototype. Okay, so after just a little bit of back and forth, and I'll just explain what I did really quickly, we were able to get this to work with the Perplexity API key. So first, let me show you how it works. So if I say who won the Super Bowl this year and ask the question, and this really only took me about like 5 minutes of back and forth. And if I did this from scratch, this would have probably taken me at least an hour, if not multiple hours, to get it to look this good. So here we can see it's showing the citations, it's giving us the answer, and it's also giving us related questions. And this is all from the Perplexity API and just plugging into the template that it had here. So then if I click which team has the most Super Bowl wins, it's going to then ask that question. And then here we go, we get a response, which is pretty awesome. And we also get related questions to keep going down the rabbit hole. So pretty cool that that all worked. And then just to show you the changes, I just had to make sure that it was using the correct API model, Sonar. So this is something that you have to do sometimes when you are working with API models in Bolt, is just make sure that it gets these little things correct, which you can tell when you get error messages when you're trying to make it work. But otherwise, it worked pretty smoothly. So that was example number one. So for my next example, I'm going to use this habit tracker template. And if I click on it, we can see it has this cool design. So let's go back and launch in Bolt. So it's going to do the same thing, import the repository. So it's essentially importing a GitHub repository into Bolt here. And here we go. So now just right off the bat, I think this is going to work. So let's see if I add a habit. I added run as a habit. I can go ahead and check these off. It's Tuesday. It knows it's Tuesday, so it's checking that off. I think it has these two by default here, just in the template, which you could remove if you want. Let's see if the quote is just the daily inspiration, which I assume would change every day. So right off the bat, this works really well. So let's say we want to do is add 10 inspirational quotes and let the user press a button to randomly show a different quote. So I'm just going to add this like little piece of functionality so you can see what's possible. Now, a very obvious other thing that we could build is connect to Supabase, add accounts, and start building more SaaS features onto this template. But I just want to show you how easy it is to start modifying the template. And now here at the top, under Daily Inspiration, I can click this button, and it's showing us different quotes, which is pretty cool. So now what I'm going to do is show you a Bolt tip that I promised in the beginning that's going to help you when you're building with Bolt. A lot of people miss this, but here on the bottom, there's this button now called Discuss Mode. So if you turn on Discuss Mode, what you can do is ask it questions, which is going to, first of all, use less tokens than if it didn't ask questions and it just started building. But it's also going to help you plan with the AI what you want to build before it starts going into that build mode, which again, uses more tokens, takes more time. So let's say, you know, I want to ask a question. How do I add a Supabase integration to add user authentication with Teams, so that multiple people can see the same streaks together? So let's say I want to ask this question. I'm in discuss mode. I'm going to send it as discuss mode. And what it's going to do is now create a plan for us to implement. And then what we can do is either keep discussing or just click implement this plan. So this is going to give you better results because it has set up a plan. It's going to allow you to review it, make sure that you understand it. And it's going to use less tokens than if you did this and then you wanted to go back and make changes. So this tip, I highly recommend you implementing when you're building in Bolt. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more content like this for free. And check the link in the description to go to nocode.mba if you want to learn more about how to build with AI and no-code tools. NoCode MBA is a learning platform with dozens of in-depth tutorials teaching you how to build from scratch, fully-fledged apps, automations, and websites. Check the link in the description to view all of the courses. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next video.